This is the solution to written homework 31. So for part A, okay, so it looks like this. So we've got a vertical line at x is 2. We've got another vertical line at x is 5. We've got a horizontal line at y is 3. And then we've got a horizontal line, a sloped line of y is x plus 4. Okay. So I need to make this just a little bit taller. So at 2, this would be 6, so I'll say that's 6, so this drawing's not exactly to scale. And then at, that's pretty good actually, so at 5 it'll be 9, so about right here. So the region that's being rotated is this one. Okay, so now we're going to rotate this around. We're going to rotate this around the x-axis, and the way this is different from the previous written homework exercises is that this is a gap. That's a gap. So we're going to rotate it around this axis, and the result is going to look like this. So we have this line at y is 3. This. And it also gets reflected down. To y is negative 3. And we have these points, so and here, and we also have this point here and here. And what's happening is that this opening right here is going to be a gap. That's a gap. And then we've got this and that and this and that and back here we have. So what this shape is, it's difficult to see just on a sheet of paper, but it is like this whole solid, so this whole solid, where this is solid, and then minus this little cylinder in the middle. So it's like that little bit has been carved out. Okay, and in fact, that's how we'll answer part C to compute the volume. So for part C, to compute the volume, we'll compute the volume of the bigger one and then subtract the area of the smaller one. Okay, so then for the bigger one, the integral will be the integral from 2 to 5 of pi times the radius squared . Okay, so we'll do that quick because it's similar to previous homework exercises. So this is pi over 3 and then x plus 4 cubed from 2 to 5. So this division by 3 is because of the power rule. So then evaluating this, this would be pi over 3. And then what? So when you plug in 5, you get 9. So 9 cubed. And then minus, when you plug in 2, you get 6. So 6 cubed. Okay, so 9 cubed minus 6 cubed is 513. So that's 513 pi over 3. And 513 is divisible by 3. So 171 pi. So the big piece has volume 171 pi. The little piece . Well, if you wanted an integral for its volume, that would be the integral from 2 to 5 of pi, and then its radius is just y is 3. So pi times 3 squared dx. And of course, this is just a constant, pi times 3 squared. That's 9 pi. So that's 9 pi times this. Well, I guess I'll use the fundamental theorem not to make things too convoluted. So this would be 9 pi, simplifying that constant, and then multiplied by x, and then evaluated from 2 to 5. So 9 pi times 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is 3, so this is 27 pi. So the area of the shape, the volume of the solid requested is the difference of these two volumes. 171 pi minus 27 pi. 171 minus 27 is 144.